Previously on Chained Echoes, the party ventured into the Empyrean ruins and fought a giant statue with an annoying defense gimmick. They also met the Vaan, who seemed helpful at first, but then it turned out they were responsible for instigating several past wars with the Grand Grimoire. At the end of the dungeon, the Church's Seraphomer pilot, Endart, challenged the party to determine who is worthy enough to use the Grimoire against the Vaan. Finally, Amalia made a meal for the party by picking the correct dialogue choices. Help me! Bark! Barking up the wrong tree? Untie me! I've seen a lot in this world, but a talking goblin is new. A dinner-ready goblin. What a scrumptious luck. Leave him, Grandpa. He can talk. You can't eat something like that. What happened to you? The people of Basil Pie was a goblin and tied me up here. But you are a goblin. Insolence. Do I look like a goblin? Green skin, bald head. Yeah, actually you do. Poppycock. So does the guy over there. Do you call him a goblin too? My name is Bark and I'm a human. Untie me. Thank you, I'll get the villagers. They claim I could be one of the beasts that have been haunting the village for months. What's wrong with me? Why is talking so hard, so suddenly? Gah! You're lucky to be alive. They probably felt sorry for you because you can talk. They would have made short work of a regular goblin. Where are you going? To the village and talk to the people. A goblin's dilemma. See what Bark is up to. Those are quite the large monster tracks. This is where the monster went on a rampage. As if we didn't have enough problems with the goblins, inhabitants who suddenly disappear in the whole political situation. Bark couldn't possibly have done this. Look at these paw prints. Just like in Jan's house, you recall. I wonder how he and his daughter have been since then. Hello, Marcia. What are you doing here? It's you. Hello. Dad told me to wait here. Some people are inside right now and they're having a serious word of Dad. Look around, and we saw you moving the bodies away. You guys are out of your minds. I'm already an outsider in Basil, but for you to insinuate I had something to do with a monster. Oh, it's you guys. These people are completely out of their gourds. They think I'm in cahoots with a monster. A monster that almost killed my daughter Marcia. Hear me out. Back then, the Tyrrhenian soldiers that had fled the Farnsport banquet had taken my daughter hostage so I would get them passes over the border. Before I could do anything, the monster had killed them all inside my home, nearly killing Marcia as well. Come on, Jan, you have to understand our point of view. What's going on outside? Marcia! Oh no, is she dead? Look, goblins are attacking! Marcia, get away! Oh wait! Noria? Damn! What was that, Bark? Wretched creatures? Are you alright, Marcia? Yes, the goblins came suddenly. Everything happened so fast. They're alive, but they're badly wounded. Can't anything be done against these pests? They're devastating our village, and they must be responsible for the disappearance of some of the villagers as well. I'm sure of it. We could talk to the goblin elder again, but the last time was already quite futile. Another goblin who can speak. How surprising. I'm not going to that village again. You're a clan, aren't you? Can't you able to act as diplomats in this conflict? Well, I think that also falls under our purview as a clan. I'm all for it. Let's help them, Glenn. Wonderful, you'll reach your village through the Ograin Grottos. I was told if you wear this emblem to let you enter. Take it. And Jan, take care of your daughter. She has only you. Let's get going. Goblin Crest. Roque Labor. So I guess that means we can go through. Gob Dalsim. Goltok Blemo, Gobda Nuk. Tokla Bargon Sepok, Gnagan Tel Nari Tok. Tasty Humans? What? Dan Tol Negoshtarg. There's a glass of some kind of liquid. Drink it? Why should we? Nagaga Blorgnos Plorda Blorg. Can't pronounce. These goblins are disgusting. I find them quite cute. They look like little green grandfathers. Blogin Dolorian Snort Gnor Bar. Glor Tree Wygron Te Mnol Gnor Fek. Get to Leaf Fro Neck. Tenno Blasi. Huh? Magic Poland. Oh, there it is. Hall. Dalio Nerf Nakos. Oh, I can buy stuff from you. Oh, I can buy more of those berries. Now I can actually take on those really annoying enemies. I'm gonna buy 99 of them. That'll weaken them to a manageable degree. Why are there four doors? Weird. Humans, huh? What are you doing here? And why are your heads still in your bodies? We are here on behalf of the village of Basil. You followed us. I did not come to hear the rest. Village Elder, please stop the attacks on our village. Har, idiots, why should we spare you humans? You make short work of us too. You slaughter every goblin you see without remorse. It's even on your sword. I smell it. Goblin blood. There must be some way to make a deal. No, get out. If you're not out the second, I'll send a whole village on you. That's the only promise I'll make. Good thing I bought all those berries, because I feel like I might not be able to get back in easily. Damn, this conflict can't find a peaceful solution. Ah. No rub Philo Nargan. Borg, it's you. Can't you talk anymore? Hello, Treg. Feh. He looks very upset. Don, danger! Your daughter! What danger, my daughter? Ra! Marcia! Seems Bark's the only diplomatic one here. After him! Human language? A book for teaching goblins the human language. It can also be used the other way around. Allows communicating with goblins. Destroys otherwise indestructible weed in Perpetua. That could be useful. Make sure to buy these two. I'm sure they'll all say bye? Yeah, they're all translated now. You fill a pack of unwashed shapes. Good thing you don't understand me. My husband went up the surface and didn't return. I'm worried some people humans got him. I lost the key, damn it. Where and when? I don't remember. I was at the western mushroom fields over there. I should take a look. But first I gotta keep an eye on these strangers. Key? Western mushroom fields. Apparently this is a suit made out of humans. Horror, foolish humans. We goblins are actually vegetarian. We wouldn't touch any stinking animal or human meat. Let's scare them. Tracy humans! I'm the best at human language directly after a boss. Hey, I pissed in the ball over there. I hope they drink it. What? Good thing I didn't drink it then. The person who wrote the Neo Seeker guide did, though. Too bad for them. There are no males or females. They're only goblins. This is Goblin Village. Something's shining over there. The heck? Miner's key? Wait a minute. Can't I use this? I can use this in the Cortara Mountain Pass, actually. But there's also that goblin I saw in the past before. I need to experiment with that at some point. Oh no, Marcia! Oh god, no! Gya! They don't even shy away from children! Look out! Ring the goblin down! No, don't tell me! Huh. No. It's just her clothes. Does that mean she's still alive? Where's Marcia? Horror, such drama. Give us that goblin. They belong to us. Why should we? Where's my daughter? What have you done with her? Ah, daughter. Danger, no! Nork, dangerous! Daughter, dangerous! My daughter is dangerous? Bork is right, your daughter is too dangerous for you. Look, she's right in front of you and she wants to kill you. What? Stupid humans, yes, we made the villagers disappear. But we don't just kidnap them, we turn them into goblins. What? The girl also became one of us, that's why Bork and Yara tried to get her earlier. This can't be. Wasn't there a noticeable number of injured people close to her? The Turinian soldiers, the villagers. Well, the transformation takes a few weeks. People change back and forth. During the transition, it sometimes happens that they get ogre powers. Har, these are the beasts that ravage your village. It's the humans who become goblins. Har. Nah. I read about this transmutation, but assume goblins are incapable of such high magic. That's right, you think goblins are stupid. You look down on us. That is the problem. That's why there will never be peace. Now give us the goblin. She is one of us. Never. If it has to be, then by force. That's a lot of them. These are all high-level goblins, too. Weak to earth, crap. Yoko Giri. Healing. Well, how about an AoE? Okay, another Yoko Giri. Heaven's Tear. Nah, you'll win for now, but we will return. We will seek out our god, and with his blessing, you will stand no chance. Come, Bark, to our sanctuary in the White Grand Mines. The mines? Do we chase them there? So that's why they had the Miner Key. Good thing I stole that key from them. Marcia. A tragedy indeed. So all these goblins were once humans, huh? You can't tell anyone about this, or they will make short work of Marcia. I'll hide with her. She won't hurt anyone. But what for? She can't even seem to take her human form anymore. I'll find a way. Somehow I'll be able to turn her back. Please. Promise me not to tell anyone about this, at least until the cure is found. We'll wait at least a few days. Maybe her condition will change. But we won't wait any longer than that. The villagers need to know that with every dead goblin, they bury a human. Thank you. Thank you very much. There's a cave behind my house. That's where I'll hide. Marcia will become human again. I know it. Hopeless, you ask me. Luckily, no one asked you. Don't say that. I wish she would come back too, but how's that going to happen? Well, we may never find out. There has to be a follow-up quest, right? Now that I have this key, I have to explore more. Okay, I can start getting rid of these guys by using the berries I bought. Bunch of money. Sacred water. Aha, a class emblem statue. We look to pray the heroes of Leonor. Yes, please, let's see what we're up against. Let me guess, multiple tat eyes. I greet you, adventurers of Valindis. My voice echoing through with my heart, shall I bestow upon me the power of ages long gone by? Okay. Show me what you got this time. I may have to use multiple berries. Oh no, they're not debuffed anymore. So I have to use my berries again. I didn't realize it could wear off that quickly. What? Oh shit, is this- it's a time limit. I'm working on a time limit, aren't I? I'm actually screwed. I have to restart a battle. This is pretty bad. Problem with this is that the berries actually have a time limit on them. And they only work once, so even if it wears off, they will still attack you. charging revenge. Not good. I don't know how long I can keep this up. Tiger and Dragon, so I can use this to instantly wipe one of them out. Heaven's Tear. My DPS centered strategy seems to have worked. And I also got to see Mika's ultra skill, so that was pretty good too. You know, Master Challenge. Might be better to come back later with the next weapon tier, since this is kind of a DPS check. Friendsworth the Mage Warrior. Alright, that solves that. Yeah, since the berry effect will wear off eventually, it is really a DPS check. I may want to think about setting up Mika better so that maybe I can get a real DPS sep going. Then again, yeah, switch out Glenn when possible. Maybe after Victory does his stuff. Okay, fast travel location. But what awaits me at the end here? What kind of horrible being awaits me here? Pedestals? The heck? Looks like an item would fit in here. Alright, so I have to defeat the Vins without going into overdrive. Is that possible? It might be. If I use spam restraint, I can probably actually pull it off really easily. Yeah, I did it. Okay, swap. It really doesn't matter what I do as long as I'm making progress. Poison shot. Swap. Aura. Swap. Double steps. Swap. Broken accordion. Swap back to you. Dragon Fang. Okay, swapped every turn, got this little achievement. Nice. Okay, this time, none of those Tadeyes spawned here, which means the boss version should be here somewhere. There it is. Barry, Senior Tadeye. Yeah, I have working on a time limit, so... Let's use Drunken Master. Yikes! Hits really hard in this situation, huh? Strength Dance. Okay. No. Dragon Fang. It's really strong still. Heaven's Tear. What is with this defense? Holy moly. I think I have to come back later. Okay, Tiger combo, so I have to use Tiger Rush. Dragon Fang. Attack stance. Okay, charging revenge self. Super move. Next turn, Sienna, so she can keep spamming. Dragon Fang. What? Okay, I'm charged up, so I'll use Final Blossom. Earth Strike. Uncanny encounter. Okay. I have to start my combo all over again. Honestly, I should probably finish off with the ultra move. Yes, did it! Now we have the key, we should be able to use this. Huh, no one's blocking the way anymore. And the key works here too. What are you doing here? Didn't I lock the door? We are on our pilgrimage to the sanctuary, leave now. Don't you dare to serve our pilgrimage. We goblins do not age. Some of us have lived for 100 years. But I've heard that goblins in other parts of the world have short lives. Does this mean we're a special kind of goblin? Humans, you don't plan to destroy a totem, do you? I kept telling the chief to keep the attacks on humans down. I explained to him that we were drawing too much attention to ourselves over and over again. For centuries we have gotten noticed, but now you have come. Oh, poor Marcia. I wonder if I'll ever be able to see you smile again. This old man is keeping me in prison here, but he's too strong for me to escape him. Huh? Wait, are you not Marcia? Did you pick the wrong goblin? Oh, shoot. Wait. There's a note. Things are getting serious. I hear more and more goblins approaching. Their drums and laughter echo throughout the caves. I don't have much time, so I'll be brief. My name is Joan Flavenberg, and I'm a journalist. I'm investigating the strange happenings in Nisa. This totem, which the goblins worship like a sanctuary, is directly connected to the university. The scholars of Nisa, for some reason, collect vast amounts of ether and will stop at nothing to do so. They know very well that a living being produces the most ether. Of course, they can't just execute people. Instead, they have built this totem that has a magical effect on people, in the radius of several kilometers. It transforms them. The text ends here. The page is full of blood. Darkness tablet. Do not touch a totem. If it's destroyed, then... Do you want to set the totem on fire? Yes, let's destroy it. Hope this doesn't have any lasting consequences. What happened? Where am I? Why am I in this cave? I can't remember anything. I feel weird. My hands look so old. Yesterday, I celebrated my 11th birthday with my family in Basil, and now... Looks like we broke the curse, so it was this totem that held a spell over them. Why did some transform back and some turn to dust? I guess they returned to human form, but aged accordingly. Some goblins must have been over 100 years old. Turning back meant their death. How cruel. I hope this was the right decision. Now, let's help these people return to their families. Okay, so she did turn back to normal. Look, Marcia turned back. It was some time ago, but we were still hiding in case she turns back. What? It was your deed. You have helped me once again. How can I thank you? Here, take this. Elixir. Repair kit DX. Platinum nugget. Just one more day, and if nothing happens, we return home. We'll start a new life. Oh, how wonderful. Why is Papa crying all the time? And why are we staying inside his cave? Just one more day? Okay, you're jinxing it. You're probably gonna get hit by a meteor or something. Okay, I should have killed a few unique monsters by now. Golden Boar found its master. Congratulations. Keep up the good work. Hello there, the Royal Dragon is defeated. Nice. Elixir. And money? Keep up the good work. Hello there, Senior Tadai said goodbye. Thanks to you. Rusty cards. Keep up the good work. That's it for now. Okay, there's an enemy I actually forgot about. Harry Otter. What? Crates automatically attacked, huh? Yes, yeah, so it's supposed to appear only when you have a total mage party. Hmm. But I can still swap out to Glenn. Berserk. You're like, own. Bird eye. Light. Weak to dark. Okay, then dark spear. Heaven's tear. Hmm. Valor Minuet. That's a lot of healing. I can't deal that much damage at once. I see, so maybe I should take this on my sky armor then. That's ridiculous. Charging revenge. Restrain. Heal overdrive. Tiger and dragon. Still not enough. Gotcha! But I didn't get the drop from it. Dang it. I'll have to try again, but with my sky armor. I fought fair and square once, and that's enough for me. For recording's sake. Hello there. No more magic tricks for Harry Otter, I've heard. Sweet times 10 and some money. Oh no, he turned back to normal. This guy, merchant. So strange, I just woke up. What am I doing here? You want to shop? Am I a merchant? Oh boy, what's going on? He can still sell the berries. But I have too much array. Drunken Master? It's never enough. Can I just hit them all with Power Armor Salvo? It also takes off a huge chunk of my hit points, too. Impossible. Ether Sucker. Wind Jump. Please work. Yes, I did it! It was close, but I pulled it off. That was such a ridiculous one. Seriously, some of these are basically say wait until the end of the game when you have enough offensive stats to make up for any of their limitations. I also get the Soul of Farnese, and now all I need is 8 more for the monument. Wait. There should be more than 8 nodes left, though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, so I don't actually have to complete every single node in order to get every single reward. Well, every single chain reward. Okay, I think I can enter this building now, can't I? You unlock the door with the church key. There's a hidden switch behind the painting. Hit the switch. Okay, is there a new path? Do I have to solve a puzzle here? Find the hidden stone tablets. In Valindis, help of Leonor and force in the west and east, finally mountains. The texts were for the most part illegible, but with some time the party is able to figure out the free locations in Valindis. Okay, it's marking off some new locations. Yeah, they all look the same from the outside, but once you get inside, they all have different puzzles. These Leonor challenges. Three orbs at once. Left, up. Down. Right. Up. Right. Down. Down, left, up, right, up, right. Okay, that's one down. Right, down, left, up, right. Rusty Spear. We like to pray to heroes, yes. I think this might be my last Sacred Wars, though, so I might have to wait until later to get the other statues. Alright. That's a lot. Alright, we got way too many guys here. Okay, you're weak to water, so water jump. Got him. You master challenge and prove myself worthy. Now give me the emblem. Mephosilis the Rune Knight. Now go forth, brave warriors and curious adventurers, for few are the future of Eldria. And teleport me all the way back here. Okay, this is somewhere on the west side of the continent. Alright, that one was way easier. I was probably meant to do this one first. Alright, let's offer this one of my last two sacred waters. Okay. Please finish talking. Five golems. That's so many. Hex dance. Water jump. And wiped out. Yeah, as long as the RNG doesn't go too bad against you, you might be able to do it. Yeah, master the challenge. Okay. Except the emblem offered by the gambler. Now go for it, brave warriors and curious adventurers, for fear of the future of Eldria. Now, if I could recruit two more party members, that would be great too. Then I could actually have more room to throw all my emblems on them. Left. Up. Right. Left. Up. Right. Down. Left. Up. Right. Down. There. Don't know why it stopped so awkwardly there. But whatever. Problem solved. Rusty amulet. Pray. Should be the last one. Probably the toughest of the challenges, huh? Okay. Speed up. Bird Eye. Get everyone debuffed. buff. Hmm. War jump. One of them survived. Not anymore. Okay, the Pyromancer emblem. That's an oddly specific one. Found 12 class emblems. Thanks for tuning in to this Let's Play of Chained Echoes. If you enjoyed, please leave a like, subscribe, and or hit the bell icon.